According to the Executive Director of National Environment Management Authority, NEMA, Badirega Akankwase, water from River Katonga has started reaching Luela wetland and it's also increasingly getting flooded. If no quick intervention is taken to stop sand mining and cultivation of rice in Luela, Akankwase says the worst might occur at Luela.
Much more worried about how the two will actually characterize flooding in Luela, not Katonga. Because the reason why we have sand mining in Luela is because the lake over time deposited sand in the Luela system. And depositing of this sand raised the Luela area slightly above the Katonga area. That's why Katonga area receives more water than Luela. So if we play around with the sand deposits there and we remove that sand, there is a likelihood for Katonga water to actually flow more to Luela, thereby causing more flooding of Luela. So the bottom line is we must manage the sand mining and we must manage the rice growing.
He was speaking during the ongoing manifesto week at the office of the Prime Minister in Kampala, where they are giving accountability on the progress so far made on the first 2 years of the implementation of the NRM manifesto. Akankwasa further warned that the rains are to also continue until late June, which will still cause further flooding.
What we see now is that we need to do more to suppress development in sensitive ecological systems.
It is not the Minister of Water and Environment alone. Each and every Ugandan should ensure that the environment is protected.
NEMA officials highlighted a number of achievements made in the two-year period, including the construction of the Nyamwamba River in Kasese, the delivery of 30,000 litres of clean water to Chirudu Hospital and surrounding areas, distribution of 45 million litres of water in central Kampala, construction of Chemishama Dam in Mbarara, construction of Chahi Dam in Gomba and Lemisuyu Dam in Nakapiripirit and Amudat. Other districts where clean water has been delivered include Katosi, Sembabule, Kapeka, Fort Porto, Hoima and others. Water distribution in all cities in the country is said to be in good shape with 74% and they expect to reach 86% by 2026. Construction of sewage in inaccessible areas is also progressing with 4,022 boreholes being constructed across the country. Story compiled by Jalet Namoya for the news.